We should play a game. Let's play I Spy. Play a game. Yeah, let's play a game. I Spy with my little eye. Do you want to play a word game? That's not. Never. That's not what I wanted. You're saying very inane things today. Boy, if you don't play with me. We're back again to play some games. We're back with Ikimasu and Goku, and last time we defeated Kenyo. I think, did it count as a confession? Anyway, me and Nobunaga like confessed our love to each other. There was no I love yous. It was just, give me your heart. So before we start, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Follow me on my social media. It's always in the description below. And we can get started. Nobunaga woke up the next morning with Lauren still resting peacefully. Are you still asleep? She was smiling in his arms, her breath soft and calm. Lauren. He wanted to reach out and touch her cheek, but he stopped himself. No. You should rest. He moved carefully, easing his arm out from under Lauren. Getting out of his warm futon, Nobunaga felt the crisp warm air on his body. I feel strangely calm. What's been wrong with me lately? He looked silently down at Lauren for just a moment before leaving the room. Nobunaga had no way of knowing just how gentle a look he'd just given her. After all the trouble we had, I'm impressed we're able to get on the road so quickly. The morning after the battle with Kenyo, Nobunaga's men were already running around getting ready to depart. Thanks to Yasu's medicine, the victims of the poison were able to recover much faster than expected. Got a little doctor. Even those who are not completely well did what they could to help prepare. I'm certainly back to normal, thanks to Yasu. I suppose Nobunaga had something to do with that too. I kept an eye out for Nobunaga while helping the ones who needed assistance. Where did he go? I thought he'd sleep in late again. But with war on the horizon, I'm kind of glad he didn't. Everyone will be needing him. I'm interested to know how me and Sasuke are gonna act when we see each other. Because we're bound to see each other. Eventually. Soon. As of tonight, your heart belongs to me.
My heart?
You're not allowed to die. I won't allow it. Nobunaga's confession the night before had left a deep impression on me. He said he didn't understand his feelings, but I was happy he tried to express them. The heart I'd given him last night was beating happily in my chest.
I wonder, is it just this time period? Or did something happen to freeze his heart?
What kind of life did he lead that he can't see what a good man he really is? I clasped my hands over my heart, when suddenly I noticed a crowd near the village entrance.
There he is.
Nobunaga and Hideyoshi were at the front of a group of soldiers. The men were fanned out, spears ready as they watched something with wary eyes.
Is it a bear?
What's going on over there? I hurried over to see. They're being hostile.
Uh-oh, here we go.
Oh, they're interrogating him, maybe? Execution.
Look at me, Kenyo.
Kenyo was tired and made to kneel before Nobunaga, but his eyes were defiant. Kenyo's men, also bound and kneeling, surrounded him.
Do I want to watch this?
No. I have a stake in this too. Before we send you to Izuchi, I did ask you something.
Oh. They're gonna send him back home?
Oh, put him in prison?
What is your question?
Has a man named Mitsuhide Akechi been involved in any of the attacks you have made on Lord Nobunaga?
We want to know. Tell us the truth.
Hideyoshi, I hope you get the answer you want.
Where'd you get that idea?
Kenyo looked surprised and a little affronted. I despise the very sight of Nobunaga, yet you think I would join hands with one of his detestable underlings? Hideyoshi seemed to hold his breath for a moment.
Alright then. That's good news.
The rumors were just rumors after all.
I couldn't stand next to Hideyoshi. Though we kept a cautious eye fixed on Kenyu, I knew he had learned what he hoped to. Is that all you want to ask me? If so, we're done here. Kenyu glared at Nobunaga with hatred in his eyes. Chill. You should kill me now, Nobunaga. No, I don't think I will. That's a change. What? Kenyu looked like he didn't understand. Around him, his men gave each other confused looks. I stole a glance at Nobunaga. I'm happy he's not gonna die, even though he's a nasty jerk. But what's Nobunaga thinking this time? Nobunaga's expression was opposite of what he'd shown me last night. It was cold and unreadable. Don't make me laugh. Is this show of compassion your way of mocking me? I was born without compassion, and that hasn't changed. I'm not like you, wasting your life on a sentimental cause like revenge for your brethren. Being a little harsh, aren't we? For a second, I thought I saw a shadow across Nobunaga's face. It was only there for an instant, replaced by a cruel smile. No, letting you live isn't compassion. It's how I'm going to punish you. You'll spend the rest of your life in the dungeons of Azuchi, watching as I accomplish my goal of conquest. Devil. If you want, think of it as a way of me thanking you for all the valuable pawns you cost me. Nobunaga, that's cold. You'll regret not killing me here. Kenyo growled through gritted teeth. Nobunaga ignored him and ordered his vassals. Take him away. Take him away.
That's a pretty cruel kind of punishment. Yeah.
Yes, my lord. A group of vassals have been selected to escort Kenyo and his men back to Azuchi. Do not let him go. Don't mess this up. I followed Nobunaga with my eyes as he directed the rest of his forces. He didn't look happy or relieved. Yesterday's battle was just one of many for Nobunaga. Still, it was one trial out of the way. I gave Hideyoshi a smile. So assuming Kenyo isn't prophetic? So assuming Kenyo isn't prophetic, that means we're finally done with him, right? Finally, he gave us quite a headache. I joined Hideyoshi in helping lead the preparation for departure. So I think me and Hideyoshi, we cool now. It was a rough start, but we cool now. Everyone else, I don't really have an opinion about them. Yasu can still catch these hands. He's rude sometimes. He was a little kinder last episode, though. Only after I proved my worth. I suppose it wasn't so bad, since I was able to clear Mr. Hide's name. I'm happy for you, Hideyoshi. I heard Mr. Hide's back at Azuchi, working on some unrelated assignments. But Kenyo's going to Azuchi, so they'll both be there together. See, I don't know how to feel about Mitsuhi. I mean, he's a snake, obviously. I said that before. I don't know. Because we really don't know who he's working for. Like, where's his loyalty? He might just talk to Kenyo when he gets there. They might plan something, or he might just keep him locked up and do as he's told. Who knows what Mitsuhide will do? He's a wild card. I heard Mitsuhide is back in Azuchi working on some unrelated assignment. Once we get back, hopefully Hideyoshi and Mitsuhide can finally make up. Don't get complacent, Lauren. The toughest battle lies ahead. I'm ready. I haven't forgotten. I like his eyes so much. His eyes are so nice. It's like ice. Like winter. His whole design is like winter. Anyway. We won last night, but that battle wasn't even what we came for. We've still got to take down Kenshin and stop his plans for invasion. We lost a considerable amount of fighting strength in that battle. Adding in the men Mitsunari and I brought, we're still short the number Lord Nobunaga departed with. The Kenshin Takeda forces aren't expecting us, but we'll still have to take extra precautions. I know, and I'll help any way I can. I picked up some skills as a Shadowlane. I can help take care of the wounded too. Alright, just don't put yourself in danger. Oh, I will. Protect yourself first. He patted me on the shoulder. Stay close to Lord Nobunaga. That's where it's safest. Let him protect you, and don't fuss about it.
Boy, I'll protect him. I'm the hero in this story.
But don't get in his way either. That's the Hideyoshi I know. We'll be departing soon. Go catch up with him. That's where I'm going. I'm a little giddy to see him, actually. Giddy. I went to find Nobunaga, my heart pounding impatiently. This is not what I pictured. I glanced back at Nobunaga, sitting on the horse behind me. We've been traveling for hours. Traveling in silence. I might as well be riding with a handsome statue. Ugh, why hasn't he said anything? He just held the reins, eyes looking ahead. I decided to try chatting. We should play a game. Let's play I Spy. Does he know that game? So, Nobunaga. Yes. Nice weather today, don't you think? He didn't answer for a moment, like my question had reached him at the bottom of a well. I suppose it is. That was the end of it. I tried to think of something else to say and failed. Let's play a game. Nobunaga had nothing more to say himself. The end. Where's the chatty Nobunaga from yesterday? I'm preventing you from doing any more of your tricks. I really wasn't gonna tickle you. It's too late. I don't trust you. But now if you tickle me and send me off the horse, you'll be dragged down with me. That definitely doesn't sound like any fun. That's the point. Now you have to behave yourself. Alright, I guess you've defeated me. I'll stop my wicked ways. See that you do. Shall we tickle him? I wish I could see that fun smile again. And now that I knew my feelings for him, I want that so much it hurt. I don't actually know what makes him laugh or smile. I combed my memories for ideas, but I couldn't pick out any particular thing. Well, this is okay too. It's not like I need to talk. I don't mind having some quiet time. Honestly, just the sound of his breathing was sweet to me. We continued to travel, the cloudless sky stretching endlessly above us. There are no birds out today. It's really quiet. It is. He responded. I got him. Now what do I say? I love this air. Wanna play a game? Yeah, let's play a game! I spy with my little eye. Do you wanna play a word game? That's not. Never. That's not what I wanted. A word game? You're asking me to play a word game? Sorry, Mr. Sengoku Warlord, who's too good for word games. Not anymore, I take it back. I hurriedly receded my suggestion. But a tiny smile appeared on Nobunaga's face. You're saying very inane things today. Boy, if you don't play with me. I'm gonna play. Yes, but I did get a smile. I was pleased and smiled myself. I guess I'm just a big old fool. But Nobunaga gave me a funny look. He grew quiet, and another chance for conversation slowly died off. Back to silence, and no more smiling. His smile had vanished as quickly as it had come. His gaze drifted off towards the empty plain. Is something wrong? No. I wonder what he's thinking about right now. I stared at his face, handsome and distant. He's definitely different today. With another bow on the horizon, he's probably tired. But if I had thought I was interested in understanding Nobunaga before, now that I realized I loved him, I found myself desperate to know what he was thinking. Seeing him smile gave me joy. Hearing him speculate made me wonder. When he looked upset, I was upset too, and I was happy to be by his side regardless. We didn't talk on our long trip, but my thoughts filled in the space rather nicely. When night came, the army stopped and set up camp in the field. Everyone was asleep, except for the night watch and me. Restlessly, I quietly exited my tent. I never managed to get a good conversation with Nobunaga. He really seemed kind of down, honestly. I'm worried. I strolled through the camp, attracted to the light of the bonfire. Am I imagining, or is this him tending the fire? Nobunaga, what are you doing here? Slowly, his eyes drifted away from the fire as he noticed me. Lauren. Looks like I've got one more chance to see what's going on. Happy to find him still awake, I walked over to see him. What are you doing up? I thought a walk might help me sleep. What are you doing out here? That should be obvious. I'm keeping watch. Why is the commander keeping watch instead of the watchman? And where is the watchman?
The man I assigned to keep watch tonight was one of the men Kenyo poisoned.
He was hiding the fact that he'd gotten worse. I sent him back to bed. That was kind of you to take over for him. I barely sleep anyway. Having a valuable pawn, exhausted is more of a loss to me than rest. This was simply the most effective method of solving my problem. You can rationalize it all you want, but where I come from, we just call that being nice. The firelight warmed his still face. I'm still worried about him though. Who's taking watch after you? If you don't have someone, I can take the next shift. What? I'm saying you look tired, and you should get some rest while I'm here. I sat down beside him, smiling. None of your pawns are gonna do you any good if the commander gets tired. I don't need rest. I can handle watch on my own. Return to your tent, Lauren. Really? I'm here because it benefits me, but there's no benefit to you in staying here. Au contraire. That means on the contrary, by the way. I looked past the cold expression of his. See, benefit means something good. And for me, there's something good about staying here. And what is that? Well, it's being able to be with you. But will you understand that? Plus, I'd come to talk to him to find out what was wrong with him. I decided to steer the conversation back his way. It's a secret. A secret? And I'm gonna stay. Spending time with the person I love is a pretty big benefit for me. I gave him a nervous smile, urging the conversation back his way. But Nobunaga didn't speak. His expression tightened. He grabbed my wrist, gently lowering me back to the grass before falling there with me. Nobunaga? That tormented expression was so near. Just what are you? I'm the woman who loves you. I really do wonder, is this the last we'll see of Kenyo? Is he gonna stay locked up or not? And when we meet Sasuke, how's that gonna go? Cause we're friends, right? We're friends. Me and Sasuke are friends. So I'm kind of worried about that. Nobunaga's upset. He just really likes me, I think. He really likes me. He doesn't understand. He doesn't understand how much he likes me. So anyway, it's so hot in California right now, y'all. It's so hot. I'm gonna say goodbye now. Thank you for watching. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Follow me on social media. It's all in the description below. And I will see you guys tomorrow with A3. Bye-bye.